Dear students, I am Tirupati Reddy, school assistant English, ZBHS Sheila Sagar from Mulugu Mandal. As we discussed earlier in the part 1 of our video, we discussed about tenses in general, and particularly now related to the third unit of your text, that is the usage of past perfect tense. What are the rules that govern the past perfect tense, and how and why this past perfect tense is used? Let us try to understand. Say, here in this lesson, the journey, the author has used many sentences in simple past and past perfect tenses. So, if we observe this sentence from our text, it was 10:20. My father had already left. When an action takes place before a point of time in the past, the action is expressed in the past perfect tense. So here the time is mentioned here, it was 2020. Was itself is a past. Past tense time is mentioned here. Before 10:20, his father had already left. His father left his home. That means this action, I had left is the past perfect tense. So this is the condition. When an action takes place in the past, before a particular point of time, that action is expressed in the past perfect tense. So we will find many examples like this. It was 8 in the morning. I had already completed my lunch. Similar way, we can construct many sentences and we could understand how this past perfect tense is used. Here, when the action past perfect, according to the tense, past perfect tense structure, it is clear that it takes had and the verb in its a V3 form or past participle form. Had left is the past perfect tense in this sentence. So, the past action which has occurred earlier before a point of time in the past is expressed in past perfect tense. This is one condition and one rule. All the actions which have happened before a point of time in the past are expressed in past perfect tense. Let us see the second condition. So, we are discussing about past perfect tense under one condition, that when an action takes place in the past, before a point of time, that is expressed in the past perfect tense. That is first one. If you observe this sentence from the text, finally we reached Dirau. The bus from Tawang had not yet reached. In this sentence, we find two actions. The first one is they reached Dirau. The second one is the bus had not yet reached. So here these two actions, one action in the first sentence, it is expressed in simple past, and in the second sentence, the action is expressed in the had not yet reached, had reached in past perfect tense. So here the bus had not yet reached, this action happened earlier than they are reaching to Dirau. So, when two actions in the past are clearly separated by time, the earlier action, the action which has taken place before, that action is expressed in the past perfect tense. The latter action is expressed in simple past tense. So, it is clear, when two actions in the past takes place, those two actions are separated by time. The earlier action is expressed in the past perfect tense and the latter action is expressed in the simple past. This is second one. So, first one is when an action takes place before a point of time in the past, that action is expressed in the past perfect tense. When two actions takes place in the past, the earlier action of the two actions is expressed in the past perfect and the latter action is expressed in simple past tense. So the use of past perfect tense in third situation is, if we observe this sentence, we could understand. Here you see, I quickly sat down on a rock. My father laughed at my plight. If you observe these two sentences, both sentences are in simple past tense. I quickly sat down on a rock. My father laughed at my plight. So here these two actions occurred at the same time without any time gap. Under this situation, when two actions in the past happens without time gap, simultaneously, at the same time, almost, those two actions are expressed in simple past. Say both, I quickly sat down on a rock. As soon as he sat down on a rock, his father laughed at his plight. That means laughed and sat. Both actions had taken place at the same time. A little time gap. That means there is no clear demarcation of two actions. So, when two actions in the past happen simultaneously, those two actions are expressed in simple past. This is the third condition. Without a time gap, two actions happen in the past, those two actions are expressed in simple past. There is no need of past perfect tense here to express any of the actions. Both actions are expressed in simple past. Here in fourth situation, if we observe these sentences, the two actions which happen in the past are separated by verbs like before, after, because. So here, when there is no ambiguity in the relation of time, time relation is unambiguous, in both sentences past simple past is used. If you observe, see, first let us see, Sunita never saw a bear. This is sa, which is simple past. Before she was transferred to married me. That means two actions occurred and they are separated by before. There is no time ambiguity. So here two actions are expressed in simple past. Similar way, Shin closed the doors because she heard loud noises from outside. Closed, heard, both are in simple past. These two actions are clear, there is no time ambiguity by the usage of because. So simple past is used in both situations. I never met him after I left India. Met, simple past, left, simple past, after. So it is clearly expressed the two actions which occurred later and which occurred earlier by usage of this after. So under this situation, simple past is used in these situations. So normally when the time relation is unambiguous, simple past is used. By how it becomes unambiguous? By the usage of before, after, because, etc. Then the two actions are expressed in simple past. This is the fourth situation. So now it is clear where, why and how past perfect tense is used, how and why simple past is used by our discussion. Once again I repeat, when an action takes place in the past before a point of time, that action is expressed in past perfect tense. And second condition, when two actions takes place in the past, the earlier action is expressed in past perfect tense and the latter action is expressed in simple past. That means there is clear demarcation. The two actions are separated by time. The earlier is in past perfect tense, latter is in simple past. When two actions occur simultaneously without time gap, at the same time, the two actions are expressed in simple past. When two actions
occur in past tense, and they are separated by verbs like before, after, because. The two actions are expressed in simple past. These are the four conditions, four situations where we use simple past and past perfect tense accordingly. So now in your text you are given 15 sentences for exercise. You go through each sentence and identify the tense and give reason why that particular tense is used there. I think I hope you have understood where and how this simple past and past perfect tense is used. Let us see a sentence for example.
Okay, if you observe these sentences, these are the sentences taken from your exercise. Out of 15 sentences, two I am explaining here. Time flew and 5 months into my marriage, I realized it. So here, this is in simple past, flew, and realized is also in simple past. Why reason? The two actions happened in the past. So simple past is used. If you observe the second sentence, I had come home this time round for a special purpose to get married. So here had come is in past perfect tense and get married is in simple past. Why this is expressed in past perfect tense? Because it had occurred earlier than this action. So here I had come home this time round for a special purpose to get married. This is the latter action, marriage. Before that, to marry, he came home. So the first action is coming home is expressed in past perfect tense, that is had come home. Why? After coming home only got married, to get married. So this action is expressed in simple past. You have to give reason like this. First identify the tense of that particular sentence and give reason why that tense is used in the sentences. So practice it, and I hope you will do it.